wheel is turning. Oh, wow, that was fast this morning. And I'm still waiting for a picture. It says excellent connection. Hey, there we go. It says we're live.
Hello.
Yeah. How are we all today? Good morning, friends. Good morning. Slugger Puppets is the first one and says hi.
Hello, how are we doing?
Gail says, good morning. Marvelous Music Monday. Are we enjoying what feels like that extra hour of sleep from daylight savings?
Absolutely not, Gail. I feel nothing.
Yeah. Someone had a little problems.
I was up at 5 a.m. yesterday.
He really was. No, I was not. Donna slept in, believe it or not, for the first time in I don't know how long. We have Bethany here. Cold Soup is here. Brazen is here. Antisocial Alex, I'm Cassidy, Bees and Arson. I don't know how those two go together. Hi from Poland, hello from England. What are we making today? Kennedy says hello.
Hello, we are drawing a Binturong. This is Wilbur the Binturong. So we got a chance to go to the zoo a month ago. And I never finished my sketchbook page. So
correct.
I thought, you know what? I've got to do it. I've got to make this video. We had our friends from our mods were here. And
correct.
So we had a wonderful time. But it was just so busy that all I could do was just a quick little doodle. And then I was like, I'll finish it later. And then I never got around to it.
He did not.
So this is, you ready for this? That is a Binturong. Look at that face. He's like a bear cat.
That is Wilbur.
That's Wilbur the Binturong.
Mm-hmm.
He loves to chew on pears.
Mm-hmm.
That's his prehensile tail.
Mm-hmm.
And I will say, as I came to a conclusion, that Wilbur looks like...
Wallace Shawn.
Wallace Shawn. Doesn't he?
Inconceivable.
Inconceivable. So, yeah. And then this is Jake, the zookeeper, who...
Oh, we love Jake.
Just... Wilbur absolutely loves Jake and likes to climb all over him.
Yeah, Jake is like Wilbur's dad.
Yeah.
Jake is... Wilbur's obsessed with Jake. It's really cute.
Jake and Wilbur are my relationship goals.
and keep in mind, Wilbur is almost 50 pounds. So when he's on Jake's shoulders, that is one heavy animal to be holding. But he's so cute.
So, you know, essentially sometimes I'll do, if you guys, you guys can see this page, right?
Correct.
So sometimes I'll do... three panels.
Wait, no, we can't see that page. The page. Yeah, there you go. Thank you.
Sometimes I'll do three panels.
Yeah.
Sometimes two. Sometimes just one.
One page.
It really just depends on the... like this one was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It kind of depends on the events.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like how much stuff is going on or how many different mm-hmm. personalities or characters, you know. There's 1, 2, 3, 4.
Mm-hmm.
And if you count those, it'd be 5. So really, it just becomes each page is its own thought process. So I try not to make it too formulaic. I really kind of just like the twisting, the kind of like wood that they have here and the way that the tamanduas kind of just kind of curl. And so I was just kind of playing around with that. Or the clouded leopard's tail is... What did they say? It was as long as
its body. Mm-hmm.
And so I wanted to show that that length. And then, of course, the teeth. Oh, you can't see that?
No.
I asked if you could see that page.
There you go.
So you see the length of the tail here. So a lot of it is part of the storytelling.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I wanted to show Stanley catching the ball. You know, kind of thing. And so those are the events that happened.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, Donna having tea with the red panda.
Because that, talk about relationship
that
goals.
That actually happened.
I mean, hello.
You know? But, yeah. So today we're going to finish this up. So again, I did not get a chance to do anything more than a sketch when I was at the zoo. A lot of times, that's all I get a chance to do is just a sketch. So that doesn't make this any less of a travel journal. It doesn't make it any less real. It's just, it's my sketchbook. It doesn't matter when I get to do it. When I go traveling, I sketch this, at Disney World for about as long as I could. This one I finished. This one I think I only got the pencils and inks done. And this one I think I just got the pencils done. And I finished them in the hotel room. You know, it's, you know, I did this one with my friend Ashley in Leaper's Fork, but I didn't get a chance to do her dog. But I took some pictures. And I painted her service dog later on. These are things that don't make this any less real. I know people like to put rules on art, and they like to say, you know, well, it's not a real plein air if you're not doing it, blah, 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 blah. Who gives a crap? You're just making art. You're filling up your sketchbook. If you if you need to go home and do it later, a lot of times I get overwhelmed because of the noises and the people and everything else. And
oftentimes you get overwhelmed.
Yeah. And or it could be too hot or too cold, or it's raining or whatever it is. I still want to have that memory preserved in my sketchbook. It doesn't make it less of a memory because I did it at home. So don't let rules keep you from doing a sketchbook.
There are no rules.
Yes.
No rules with art, travel, sketchbooks, journals. There's no rules, guys. No rules.
All right. I am going to... You know, I've been using the same...
Marker?
Pen for... I did the entire 80s... Or the entire Octobear.
With the same pen?
With the same pen. Because it wasn't a lot of inking. It
was that's true. Well, he didn't have a... they didn't have a lot of ink. That's correct.
Yeah, so I think I'm going to get a new pen.
Okay. Emma and Steph Nerd are here.
Hey, Emma and Steph Nerd.
Let's see. Marash says, so I'm having a bit of a problem here. So kids are making fun of me for drawing, and whenever I say something, a teacher tells me off. What should I do?
Just so I understand, kids are making fun of you for drawing?
Correct.
Okay. Well, I had...
They're not having a very supportive teacher either.
Yeah, well, it sounds like the teacher is getting mad that they're telling them off.
No. Whenever I say something, a teacher tells me off. Okay. What should I do?
Don't say anything. Ignore them. I know it's hard, but put some headphones on if you're allowed to, and just ignore them. Kids are looking for attention. They're looking for a reaction. You know, we have twins, and we had one twin kind of just went through school, had no problem. The other one had problems. And the one that had problems was because they got upset when someone would say something. The other one didn't care. And I think that's what it is you're giving them, and again, this is, you're getting life advice from an artist in a hobbit hole, okay? So take that with a grain of salt. But from my experience, I got picked on a lot when I was young. I was not popular, and people would make fun of me making art or whatever too. It wasn't until I stopped caring that stopped. You know, once you stop caring, once you stop, what do you care what someone says about, you know, you're going to go on your life and do your own thing.
I think that is easier for us with perspective behind
us.
Yes. And I think at a younger age, that might be harder for people.
Yeah. Different people, you know, can handle different things because of their personality, like our two kids. And so I'm going to move this a little bit.
Okay. I'm going to go get a Kleenex over there because my nose is bothering me this weekend. Okay, or this one. My nose is bothering me. Sorry. right, guys, give us a second here. We are just having a moment.
Okay. I kind of want to bring this down here so I can see it a little better, so.
Why does that say camera not a O? Because you. Okay, thanks. Okay, it's Monday. Give us a minute for this, a hot minute for these technical goodies this morning.
I'm trying to get this closer. I had to get a new sketchbook and everything. So.
It's okay. You're good. Don't worry about it. We want to just be able to see what you're drawing. And so I think if I'm being 100% honest, I'd like to see you fold back the rhino page so that we can focus on the Binturong page.
Okay.
All of Scott's art supplies are in the resources page on our website. You can find all those there. He's using the San Francisco paint palette. And Marie is here and says, hi, friends, drawing along with my favorites this morning. I refuse to believe that was a whole month ago. There's just no way.
Oh, yeah, Anne Marie.
Time just keeps flying, doesn't it?
It's crazy.
Ellen's here.
Hey, Ellen.
Pacer's here. One Up Girl's here. Good morning, everybody. All these friends. Okay. It is 9:13 a.m. for us.
I think this should be good.
Do not fear. Kermito is here. Good morning, Donna and Scott. Oh, phew. I was wondering where you were.
All right. Sorry for the slow start. Had to get a new pen. Had to readjust the
camera.
The camera. I'm just going to record a little bit.
Cassidy says, such a beautiful sketchbook to flip through.
Oh, thank you.
Saroja was eagerly waiting for the live. Good morning.
Good morning.
Did Wilbur smell like popcorn? Yes,
Wilbur smelled like popcorn. No, Wilbur did not smell like popcorn.
Yes, he did.
Pee smells like popcorn. He did not pee. Didn't smell popcorn.
I was at a Mystic Market for my business this weekend, and a lot of people were wanting stickers, so I'm going to design some while watching. What company do you use for your stickers?
I don't. I have not done stickers yet. The one that I'm using is Crowdmade, but they're not someone that you could go to. They're like it's like an agency kind of thing that they handle all of your stuff. And
we've heard Redbubble does stickers. I know Printify does stickers, but I wasn't
Ellen
thrilled
who
with their
had
shipping.
Those really good stickers.
Yes, Ellen has great stickers. Fiber and Brimstone has great stickers. And maybe Ellen, you could share where you get your stickers done. How many sketchbooks do you have? Everybody always wants to know that. So many, you guys.
Yeah, probably around 50 or so.
Let's see. Hey Scott, this is Leon. I'm doing the 100 Pantone challenge and I finished 70 of the cards so far. I only have 30 left and I'm so excited to be almost finished.
That's amazing.
What is the 100 Pantone challenge?
I don't know, but they're almost done with it.
I know, that's pretty cool. Did the stream start late? Is it daylight savings time? Oh yeah, we had daylight savings time yesterday, so we're an hour behind. You turn your clock back.
Yeah, sorry about that. No one likes this.
Did Scott ever consider being a zookeeper, a veterinarian, or some other career involving animals?
No. I like animals. I don't want to dedicate my time caring for them. I don't like to see anybody or anything sick or so. Like I always found it so amazing how people could be doctors or nurses or you know, whatever. I just,
helpers.
Yeah, I can't do it.
Wait, how many sketchbooks do you have? I thought you only had one.
Well, I thought they meant like I have been using sketchbooks for 40 years.
Yeah.
So I've got a lot of them finished.
Mm-hmm. And a shelf full.
Yeah. And then, you know, companies have been sending me sketchbooks too that I haven't even had a chance to try out.
Yep. Okay, so yeah, it's morning for us. So, yes, it's morning. Dee Dee says good morning and evening.
Good
Just
morning.
Joined. Hi from South Africa.
Hello.
How do you guys wake up and do art? I've just been up all night 3D modeling and decided to check the stream. Well, we were not up all night.
Yeah, we're in bed by 10.
Yeah. You know, and yeah. Last night we were in bed a little bit later.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Nixie is correct. Caffeine. Lots and lots of caffeine is how we wake up. Well, Scott doesn't. I do.
I've got my yearly physical exam on
later this week.
Wednesday. And so I'm trying to lose 15 pounds before I get there because I have just... I'm not in my best shape.
No, I still love you.
Thank you.
Paul's here. Paul Porosky. How you doing, Paul?
How have you been?
Paul, I guess, has a kitten. Oh, my goodness. Been busy with work and the kitten. Well, that would keep you busy for sure. Let's see. Dee Dee says, it's honestly horrible that we live in a world where we get picked on for pursuing hobbies, which does not harm anyone. I think that's why everybody has to get better at, if you're doing something that you love, that is not bothering anybody and not hurting anybody, like drawing or art or whatever, you just need to ignore the haters. It's like Taylor Swift said, you know, haters gonna hate. I mean, and they really, there's always, well, I know, I don't know, you know, whatever. But it's people that are always gonna have an opinion. I mean, you should hear some of the stuff that Scott's heard over the years that people have said about him. People have said about bad things about our movie. People, you just have to know that what you're doing makes you happy and you're not bothering anybody and you're not hurting anybody. Then you're good. You're really good, you know, and that's okay. Bunny Blooms wants to know how you got interested in art and drawing.
My mom was an artist. She was a fashion illustrator. My uncle Ray was an artist, and actually today would have been his birthday.
Yeah.
We had an uncle Dave who was an artist, so I was kind of surrounded by art and artists.
You were indeed.
And then I think my dad wanted me to be. My dad was a. I want to say like a He-Man kind of thing, but you know, he was a boxer and played football and was in the army and, you know, just played, was a great golfer and whatnot. And I think he kind of wanted me to be a, like a football player, but I did not, you know, my dad was 6'1", something like that, you know,
yeah.
I was not as big, not as athletic, you know, et cetera, et cetera. And so I just didn't really have any other skills other than drawing.
You weren't interested either. Not interested in really anything besides drawing.
I think I might be right, I might be wrong, but I think with kids, if they have a gift for something, whether it be golf, you know, like a sport or art, if they have something and the people are like, wow, you're so good at it, then they tend to go towards that thing, you know? Mm-hmm. And so I think that was the thing that I was good at. Mm-hmm. And that's fun, you know? I like it. I do.
Anaya wants to know, when you visit the Nashville Zoo to meet new exotic wildlife, do you also visit the ones you've met before?
Well, no, because those lots of times are encounters that they set up. A lot of times
they're
those animals aren't...
They're behind the scenes or they're on a special backstage pass tour, like, that we go on?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think, you know, like we get to see like Mei Li, you know, the red panda. Mm-hmm. We get to see Felix the Sumatran tiger.
They're out on exhibit.
Yeah.
But some of the animals we've seen, like Wilbur, is an ambassador animal. So Wilbur has been raised since he was very young. His mom died, and Wilbur was hand raised very young to specifically be an ambassador animal. And what they do with ambassador animals, people always love animal encounters at the zoo. And what it opens up for people is it opens up a world of seeing an exotic animal that they've never seen before. And then the keepers can talk about conservation. They can talk about ecology. They can talk about how important specific species are to the environment and why it's important to preserve these species. And so Wilbur is very comfortable with Jake. He is not super, like, he would never climb on my shoulders, as much as I would have loved that. He wouldn't. But he is a useful animal who is not afraid of being around people. And
not dangerous to anybody.
He's really not.
It's good to... and they have like the bird shows and other things like that, you know, but again, animals, like when we were leaving our encounter with Wilbur, we met one of the other zookeepers who had a tortoise and a hare because they were talking to the kids.
They
and
were so doing, we it was home, homeschool day.
Yeah.
Yep. And they were talking about a tortoise, but it was this rabbit was ginormous.
Oh, it was a giant.
It was one of the giant... Flemish giant, but it was a white. Oh, anyways, huge rabbit.
But you know, I think that's at least for me. And I know everybody has differing opinions on zoos and whatnot. Mm-hmm. But for me and Donna, I think we see all of the good that they're doing with educating, and they're giving money back to different places for conservancy and you know. Replenishing the rainforest and all of that stuff. So the all of the zookeepers absolutely 100% love these animals. And
the animals are their children.
Yeah, and they take care of them. They don't exploit them. Mm-mm. But you know, animals like Wilbur are used to educate, and I think that's a wonderful thing.
Yeah, and. It's very, very interesting that you can have a connection. You see people's faces, because I volunteered at the zoo for years with one of our sons. You see the connection that people make with an animal. The docents come out and they have a tarantula spider, and there are little kids that come up and they will pet spiders and snakes and all sorts of things. But the keepers get to tell them interesting things about where this spider came from. This spider came from the rainforest, and it's important to protect the rainforest so we don't lose all these different species. And guess what else lives in the rainforest with the spiders? It's these animals. We've seen how these animals are treated. And if you go to the zoo, if you go to any AZA accredited zoo, you will see how well these animals are treated. The American Zoological Association, which is the AZA, has very strict rules on how animals have to be kept, how they have to be treated, how they have to be trained and worked with, and the incredible amount of training that the keepers need before they can ever be allowed to work with an animal, any animal. And you've also got to know, too, that with conservation, I mean, it's important because some of these animals are no longer in the wild. The northern white rhinos are gone. There's two left in the world, you know? And so anyway, we love the people at the zoo. We know how important conservation is, and we see how wonderful they are and the good works that they do. Otherwise, we honestly would not be going up there all the time, guys. Yeah. We would never...
So when we did Animal Crackers,
Santa's here.
Oh, hey, Santa.
Good morning, Santa.
When we did Animal Crackers, we went to Valencia to go, you know, prepare to work, and you know, we love Spain and love my friends Jaime, and we just had a wonderful time. But one of the things that we, so see, sometimes I do hair and I go, I don't like it now. But I know that it's going to, you know, get covered up with the watercolors. But we went to go to a circus in Valencia. And
I was not there for that.
And in going to do that, we got a backstage tour, and all of the animals, like this giant tiger was in this like 6 foot by 6 foot mm-hmm. cage, and they were just, they looked miserable. And I just went, okay, we can't support this. We can't have real animals in the zoo in our film. Mm-hmm. It, like, no animals, no cages, no nothing. It has to all be, anytime you see an animal, it's a human who ate a magical cookie, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm. And I know that's a small thing, but...
it's a small thing until PETA calls you.
Until PETA calls you, yeah. But the thing is that that's kind of how we feel about, like, the zoo. Like, if we saw anything that looked, you know, bad, we wouldn't be making videos with them or
anything. We would never.
Like that, you know? Mm-mm. We love animals.
Yeah, we would never do that. And we appreciate all the hard work that they're doing. What's your favorite sport?
I would say hockey. Mm-hmm. It depends. When people say favorite, sometimes they say they say like who they like to watch, but I don't really like watching sports. Mm-hmm. But I play fantasy hockey. I used to play hockey up until maybe my mid-30s.
Yeah, until you hurt your back.
Yeah. And so it's like you like hockey, but you can't play it anymore. Mm-hmm. And then so there's that. And then I play golf sometimes. I'd like to play more, but I play golf sometimes. But there's the sport you can play and then the sport you like to watch. And I really don't like to watch sports. So
yeah, you really don't. Your dad used to love to watch sports. Yeah. My dad did too.
Yeah.
I think that's what that era did.
Yeah. You know, I guess it's okay. Like I said, for me, I'd rather play something than sit and watch it.
Okay, let's see. Yeah, all of our mod friends were like, oh my gosh, Wilbur was so cute. He was wonderful. Yeah. We cannot get Indian products here. That is one of the problems with us being able to try all of the different products. We cannot get them here. And yes, Stefnert is correct. If you're going to want something to draw, draw a red panda. First time I'm catching the stream, says Emil.
Oh, well, welcome.
Scott is using a zebra brush pen in the extra fine.
Yeah.
Point. We get ours on jetpens.com. Anaya, we would not want to make a live action film like Animal Crackers starring animals from the Nashville Zoo. We would not, that would hold zero interest for us. And you have to understand there's a lot of regulations with live action films that don't happen with animation.
You guys want to hear a funny story or a little secret? Animal Crackers was originally written to be live action. So, you know, you never know.
All the mods are like, Wilbur would have squished you. You would have been on the floor if he was on your shoulders. Oh, I know. But it would have been worth it. Ugh. The wannabe optimist says, these sketchbook entries of yours are always my favorite.
Oh, thank you.
Jerome says, I'm currently an art student and your videos always make my day. Is there an art medium you don't particularly care for?
Oil pastels. I'm not really fond of things like Posca markers. And none of these is to say I don't like art made with these. The question, I'm taking the question as, what don't you like to work in? And not you know, because I know sometimes people go, like if I say I don't really like working digitally, people go, oh, you don't like digital art? It's like, no, I think digital art's amazing. Mm-hmm. I'm just not really a fan of it.
Mm-hmm. just for the record, just because Scott doesn't like a medium doesn't mean somebody else won't like a different medium, right?
Yeah.
Like, we have that in our own house. Like, I love to work with fountain pens and glass dip pens, and he doesn't like any of that. There is an art medium out there for everyone. Oil paints and acrylic paints and oil pastels and, you know, digital art and, you know, all sorts of fiber arts, all sorts of fun things that you can do. And how great is it that there's so many things out there, right? So there's something for everybody.
Yeah.
And just because one person doesn't like it doesn't mean it's not good or doesn't mean it's not wonderful for you. Everybody gets to do their own thing. That's the great part about this.
Yeah, I love watching Black Bean's oil pastels. I think they're absolutely amazing.
Yeah, super talented.
Yeah, I just tried it and went, I'm not very good at it, you mm-hmm. know? So, you know, again, I can like something and not like working in it, mm-hmm. but admire other people's work in it.
Mocha Rain says, people who say negative things to others tend to be unhappy in their own lives, in my experience. Don't let others dull your shine. Everyone deserves happiness and joy.
Yeah.
100% agree with that.
Yeah. It's really a, like what Donna was saying is, you know, a lot of this giving up, worrying about stuff isn't something that's easy to do.
Nope.
It's really, really difficult. Mm-hmm. And some people it comes very naturally, like I said, like with our one son, mm-hmm. and another one it doesn't. Some people are just naturally more sensitive, and
I am.
Yeah, and you know, like when we go outside, I put my head down and I just go and do my thing. Mm-hmm. Donna has her head up and her head's on a swivel. Mm-hmm. She's looking to see what other people are looking at, she's wondering what they're thinking.
I don't, you know? It's only when I get looks at something for like wearing a mask or something. That's when I get really ticked off. I'm like, what does it matter to you?
But again,
you
know? I
don't look at the ground. I don't look down because, and I think this, I was thinking about this. I'm constantly vigilant. I'm constantly looking around.
You're a woman. Like, you have to be.
Exactly. And know? I think that's, yes, correct.
And so, you know, again, there's plus obviously various factors that people have to consider.
Right.
But, I you know, my thing is there is going to have to be, for you to have peace of mind, a point where you have to stop caring what people think about you. You can still be
vigilant,
but you don't have to worry what a complete stranger is thinking about you.
Correct. I would agree with that 100%. Yes. What is your favorite picture that you've painted in your sketchbook?
In this particular sketchbook, actually, I think I'm pretty proud of the my first self-portrait in this sketchbook.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of really fun sketches that I did.
Yeah.
But I just think, doing my first self-portrait, mm-hmm. I'm kind of proud of that.
Mm-hmm. My favorite thing in that sketchbook is the Arwen pages.
Oh, yeah.
But that's really not a surprise to anybody. let's see.
So, here's the thing. I did not like how the inking came out. 100%. So now, rather than staring at it mm-hmm. while I'm inking Jake and Wilbur, mm-hmm. I thought I'm going to just go straight to the paint and cover it up so that way I feel better. So please allow me this moment of weakness.
Bethany says, we are women. We have to keep our head on a swivel. It's true.
Yeah.
It's true. I would expand on that to say that there are a lot of people, marginalized people who have to do the same thing.
Yeah.
Keep their head on a swivel. And, yeah. And it's sad. It's sad that we have to walk around like that, but that's the nature of the world we live in. Ink Ivy says, I always tell my children that healthy people don't hurt other people for fun. That's a great thing to tell your kids. Sotnos is currently using a glass dip pen. I love glass dip pens. What exactly is a Binturong?
Binturong is a mythical character that you would see in something like Secret of Nim or a Jim Henson production. They're half bear, half cat, you know, half Wallace Shawn. I don't know.
The Binturong, known as the bear cat, is a vivid native to South and Southeast Asia. It is uncommon in much of its range and has been assessed as vulnerable because of its declining population. They actually live in really hot climates, which cracks me up because they're
so furry.
They're so furry. It's a little crazy. They eat fruit. They'll eat eggs of different things. So they're kind of an omnivore that way. They don't go out of their way to kill things to eat. But, how old is the clock in the background? I have no idea. Do you know how old the Mr. Clock is?
I would say it's at least 100 years old, but.
Yeah. I don't know. He's old. Scott's parents loved antiques, so I have no idea how old it is.
I know it's at least 50 years old, because it's been in my house for as long as I've been around.
Has it really?
Yeah, we had it, I think, in Florida is what I remember.
Oh, wow. Favorite Disney movie?
Little Mermaid? No. Tron Legacy.
Okay.
That was a good one.
Would like to see Scott give acrylics another try. Ha ha. Probably not going to happen.
Well, you know, TikTok has that on this day. Mm-hmm. And on this day last year, I don't know, but I tried the Hemi acrylics.
Did you really?
And I did that really cool painting of the Punisher. And I was like, that came out really good. Now, I think I could do that same thing with acrylic wash and be happier. But I think, you know, I would never say never. Blow dryer.
Okay. Go ahead. How do you have the motivation to draw and stream? It must be tiring sometimes, in my opinion.
It is, but right now, this has kind of become our job.
Mm-hmm.
And so I wake up and I go, okay, well, if I don't do this, what else am I going to do? Mm-hmm. And so it kind of becomes that. So I have that benefit of, well, this is how we're feeding the family.
Mm-hmm.
So there's that.
Oh, good. Ink Ivy says, we received our Medusa poster in the mail. It arrived totally intact, and as a gift to my 16-year-old, there was much excitement.
Oh, fantastic.
I'm so happy that you got that.
It's become so kind of a bit of a crapshoot with just mailing, no matter how well we...
No, the post office is just a... They are not doing a good job. Let's put it that way. We have had some issues. So glad to hear that, though. Do you play or watch chess?
I can play chess. I don't enjoy it that much. But, my dad was into chess. My cousins were into chess. And so, yeah, I had a lot of people beating me in chess a lot, so I guess I got a little good, but...
I had a lot of people kicking my butt in chess, so I had to up my game.
Yeah, I know how to play, and I'm not bad, but it's a little boring for this autistic person.
It's just a little slower paced. What is your favorite painting that another artist did?
Spring by Sir Lawrence Alma-Tadema.
I will tell you, a friend of ours named Tim Hodge, who also has a YouTube channel, just did a painting of Jessica Rabbit as Madame X. And it really came out nice. It was oil painting, and it came out really, really nice. You should check them out.
Blow dryer.
Hold on. Let me go ahead. All right. How's everyone doing on my not so fine rainy British day? Okay. First of all, that sounds like the perfect day because you can have a cup of tea, which in the entire rest of the world is not as good as in Britain. So that just sounds like an amazing day to me. A big sweater, a nice umbrella.
Maybe they have to go to work.
A cup of tea. Put your wellies on. It's all good.
Your wellies?
Rain boots.
Oh.
What's your advice for artists that are in burnout or losing passion in art?
For me, what helped me was changing mediums. Try a new medium.
Would Scott ever try 3D stuff, maybe like VR or just making textures for a model?
I did for many, a couple decades. I was mm-hmm. a 3D animator and, film and TV. I did a series. I did Spider-Man. I did the Dreamland Chronicles all in 3D. Mm-hmm. I never really liked modeling. I was more on the character animation side. Mm-hmm. I like lighting.
That's an understatement.
But I don't know if I'll ever get back into it. But as I always say, never say never.
You said dip pen and I glass dip pen and I got mine out, says Kalina. Yay. How do you get inspiration and practice drawing? That's Lee Zeri.
I've done a couple videos on that. Draw everything every day. Mm-hmm. 1 minute figure drawing sketches. There's so many great practices and things you can do.
What would you do without the blow dryer?
Sit and watch paint dry.
Mm-hmm. As would all of you.
Yeah, I just don't think it'd be very fun for anybody.
Hey, Scott, you had talked in a live about stomach problems. Did you ever resolve them?
I'm working on it. My stomach problems are mental. So my mind is sending the signal to my body to mm-hmm. like, time to go to the bathroom, that kind of thing. And so I've been working, I've been doing therapy, I'm trying different medicines, and what you eat definitely makes a difference, but a lot of it is, I would say 80-90% of it is just mental. Mm-hmm. And so it's a lot of that is just finding out why my body's doing it. Some of it is like a trauma response, others is we're finding out is autism. Mm-hmm. And so really it's just a lot of learning and just trial and error.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I have tried Indian chai. Have you ever painted something on a 3G surface?
I don't know what a 3G surface is. Unless they meant 3D?
Yeah, slugger puppets. I don't know. We don't know what you mean by that. Let's see.
I got a blow dryer.
Okay, hold on. Let me mute. There, go ahead. The tea of the day is the Harrod's tea. Never tried buttered chicken. Let's see. 1 second here. What's your favorite sketchbook that you filled up?
I guess I could say the hair journal. But my favorite sketchbook is the Be Creative sketchbook that I'm currently using. But the one that I like it to go back and look at that, it would probably be either the hair journal or really any of my travel mm-hmm. journal ones.
Mm-hmm. I like my Archer and Olive journals that I've filled up for writing.
Well, dark.
But I really enjoy the... Go ahead. I got a travel journal. I'm using a traveler's notebook, and I really am enjoying writing in that for travel. So I'm really enjoying using those. It's a little bit more compact, and it travels a little bit easier. So I'm enjoying that. Let's see. I'm not in the UK, but it's cold and rainy here. That's a good day for tea. Let's see. What was the name of the artist who did the desk grab painting? Oh, Tim Hodge. H-O-D-G-E.
Tim is the one who I did mm-hmm. the painting of a tree with a friend video.
Yeah, in downtown.
Which they end up cutting that tree down.
I know, that was so sad. Let's see. What's your favorite kind of fan art?
My favorite kind of fan art?
Mm-hmm.
Jeez.
Oh, yeah, they said... Go ahead.
I like fan art from kids.
Yeah. Slugger puppets have... They did mean 3D surface. Have you ever painted something on a 3D surface?
Yeah. I did... there's a video, a couple videos where I painted on an Xbox controller. Mm-hmm. That was kind of fun. It is challenging, though.
Puzzling Reed says, the gut is the second brain. That yeah. is what is coming out now in all of the studies. Okay. Is your gouache palette underneath your watercolor palette?
Yes, it is, because I was...
Wait. Go ahead.
If you remember on Friday, I was painting Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, and I want to finish it, because I this is 90 minutes, and I'm like, I think I need another 45 minutes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry. Bright Star, can you give inspiration for an artist who is losing hope? My cousin has kidney failure.
Oh, gosh.
I'm so sorry about that.
I guess, you know, the one thing that comes to mind is try to find the beauty in the world now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just find the beauty, just capture it, mm-hmm. collect it. You know, that's what I try to do is I just, you know, I was telling my mom, one of the things that I have, access to that the old masters like Monet and Renoir mm-hmm. Didn't have is I have access to the world that I, yeah. you know, I have the internet. I can, mm-hmm. I'm talking to people right now mm-hmm. from all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think my art reflects that. Mm-hmm. Travel is easier than it was back then.
Uh-huh.
You know, I can. So I can capture the beauty of the world as it is in my lifetime,
mm-hmm.
and I think that's something to aspire to do, especially when your cousin's sick and. Show them beauty. Mm-hmm. Show them the beauty. Let them see the things that they can't go out and see right now.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. It's just a thought.
Yeah. My two cents would be to just spend time with them. We have a lot of people in our life right now that are going through some pretty heavy medical things. And the single best thing that you can do is spend time with people. Honestly, nothing in this world, you come into the world with nothing and you go out of the world with nothing. And you just have the things that you see, the things that you do, and the people that you love. So spend time with your cousin because that's going to be the most important thing to have memories with them. Let's see. Have you guys ever tried Ferris wheel press ink or fountain pens? They are amazing. Please give them a go. Just the best ink. You know what? Fiber and Brimstone has Ferris wheel press ink, and I have never tried it, and I have always been wanting to try it. So perhaps I will treat myself to some samples of their ink. I would love to try that. Mocha Rain is trying to fill up one sketchbook this year. I'm nervous because I still have a lot of pages, but I'm excited for the challenge.
Oh, yeah.
I think that's an awesome challenge, an awesome way to go.
It is.
Oh, and Aya says, Scott, today my baby brother was crying because he stubbed his toe, and then he saw your face in a video I was watching, and he started laughing.
Ugh.
Even little kids understand how kind you are.
Aww. Okay, either that or have a very funny face.
I was thinking that, but I didn't want to say it.
But thank you for telling me that.
Smit wants to know how to get inspiration for completing a painting.
You know, sometimes you just don't. And, I mean, if it's an assignment for school or something that you have to finish, then you just kind of have to just do it. And for me, it's just put on some music and sing and whatever you got to do to just keep going. But, a lot of the times, I find that my attention span, like, you don't see me doing a lot of pieces like the Gothic Vampire, because I don't know if I want to spend 2.5-3 weeks on a piece. And then sometimes I want to. And so really you kind of have to look and see where your desires are. And that's why I do a lot of shorter pieces. But then sometimes I get bored and go, I want to do a bigger piece. It's that artistic struggle of, you know, you kind of need to follow where your desires are, but then you also have to finish this piece. And when I was in art school, because, you know, my major was illustration, and illustration is too bad if you don't have any motivation. You're not doing this, you know, if you want to do that, go to fine arts. Because we had a fine arts department where basically, you know, you roll around and paint and then jump into a, you know, canvas or something like that. And they go, it's beautiful. And then there's illustration, which is, this is a job. Your client needs this done. Mm-hmm. And who cares about your feelings? You just get this done and you figure out how to get this done.
Suck it up, buttercup.
Really, you just have to just kind of, I go back and forth between those two. Some days I'm like, I've got to get painting done. I've got to go live. I've got to do this. I've got to do that. Mm-hmm. And I just listen to some music and I push through it. Mm-hmm. And then other days I go, the muse just isn't with me. I'm going to go eat some candy and play video games. And
that's accurate, people. Yeah, that's 100% accurate.
But that is,
the muse has left the hobbit hole.
Yeah. That is, you know, the thing that we do as artists.
Mm-hmm. What's your favorite dessert?
Okay, there's desserts I can have and desserts like the dessert that if I could have it, it would be chocolate ice cream, chocolate syrup, all swirled and mixed up into a shake. That is my favorite thing. I will eat that till I
puke
and then poop for a week. But
you will too. It's not
desserts,
it's not
that I'm currently eating. When Donna makes snickerdoodles or chocolate chip cookies.
You're cute. My favorite dessert is chocolate cake with raspberry filling and chocolate buttercream icing. It's very specific. I shouldn't eat it. It's terrible for me. But there you go. Okay, Generally Femme says, Hi Scott, any tips for watercolor on how to get the right amount of water consistently? I keep using too much or too little, so I either wipe away paint while layering or get streaks. Any tips? And please take a long time to answer that.
Okay. I don't know if you, can you guys see the paints? Yeah, you can see. So a lot of times I will sit here and I'll go, okay, there's a lot of paint on that. You can kind of see it on the palette. You can kind of play around the palette. Some artists will have a separate piece of paper that they'll use to see how much it is, like, oh, that's too wet, or oh, that's too much paint. So sometimes you can have a separate piece of paper to just do a quick tryout. But honestly, after a while, you kind of get a feel for it. Like, I'm looking to get a little bit more opaque, and so I can see it. I could see it on the paint palette. Okay, this is more opaque. And then from there, I can kind of do that and go, yep. So I'm feeling it on the palette. and I'm seeing it swirl around. If I'm seeing more pigment on the palette, then I know that that pigment's gonna be there on the paintbrush. And so it's a lot of just swirling around on the palette until I get a good feel for it.
Okay. Blah, 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 blah. Let's see. they started talking about chess squares. Okay, so when everybody came out to visit, Bethany Primrose made this dessert breakfast treat, special treat called
Southern thing.
Chess squares. And they're so good. Oh my God, they're so good. And they go with tea and they go with coffee and they're just so good. Anyway, there you go. Please, can you review brush rinser?
I don't know what that is, but I'll look into it.
What is a brush rinser? Is it the little thing that goes on the bottom of the paint, the water bucket? Or is it something...
I need to blow dry.
Oh, you need to blow dry. Okay. Go ahead. Scott has never used a drawing glove. I don't know... if you're bored, pick up a book. I would recommend a book over a TV show. But if you want a really good movie, it's the Jane Austen BBC Pride and Prejudice is phenomenal. I think Bethany would be better to say if there's watercolor canvases, but I don't think there are.
I think someone mentioned that before, and I think there are.
I don't know.
But, I know that, Aquaboard, mm-hmm. Aqua B-O-R-D, their boards, which I used a lot, they're really good, but they actually, you can do watercolor on them too. they don't ship well.
Yeah.
They crack when you ship them though.
Yeah, I don't recommend shipping them. Mm-mm. Been there, done that. Pano Thera says, I'd like to start Art Nouveau. Could you recommend how to start? And hold that thought.
Okay, so there's no right or wrong way. The way that I learned Art Nouveau was I got a book, and there's there's a link to a similar book, because the one I got is out of print, in our resources on our website. Mm-hmm. But what I did was I got a book on Alphonse Mucha, and I just copied, not exactly, but I copied, I would find a picture of a woman, and then I would copy the composition,
mm-hmm.
and I would try to do it mm-hmm. in his style.
Mm-hmm.
And I just did that over and over and over again mm-hmm. until I didn't have to look at it anymore. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, I didn't, you know, it's like, okay, I kind of got the elements that I like, and I don't need to do that anymore.
What if they go to the library and get a book of Art Nouveau and practice drawing from there?
Yeah, you absolutely could. But really, it's just like with anything, it's just studying, copying, observing. It's how we learn. So I'm going with a light blue pencil now.
Making the fur look nice.
It's really, this is one of those things, like the inking, I was like, I don't like how it came out. And that's the thing. People keep asking me, how do you do fur? It's like literally every animal, the fur is different. Like a Binturong's fur is completely different than, a Sumatran tiger's fur. And so I'm figuring it out as I'm going. Now, if I was doing binturongs for a long time, I think I would get better at it. But really, I just didn't like how the inking was, so I wanted to cover it up with the watercolors and then come back in with some colored pencil. And that's kind of just how I figure stuff out. And if I didn't like it, I would go back in with some gouache until I get something that I like. But I think doing that gives you a sense of layers and depth, because mm-hmm. you have the inks and you have the watercolors, mm-hmm. and that kind of gives you that feeling of a lot is going on mm-hmm. in the fur here.
Mm-hmm. And I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, but because I don't want to talk about your process, but this is because you've perfected this, not perfected, but you've been using techniques for years. And so it's sort of a trial and error kind of thing. Pencil sharpener. You've tried mixing mediums. You've tried layering different things. And yeah. you know how things work. And you know, I want it. Now you're using like a
lavender
type of pencil because you're seeing lavender in the shadows.
Yeah.
Okay. So
there's a lot of purple in his furs, in his fur. And it's really interesting.
The way the light hits it.
Yeah. I'll show you guys, but...
He's a little patootie cute.
He is.
Yeah.
Okay, so take a look.
People are missing Bowie and hope they will see them next October. While you're doing that, let your brain chew on, what is the best art gift, in your opinion, to give someone? Like, for instance, a portrait of them or whatever.
I don't generally think, and this was the mistake I made, you know, like when I got to meet Ian McKellen, I did a painting of him as Gandalf mm-hmm. to give him, and it was like his not his manager, but his friend was like, he gets a lot of these and mm-hmm. doesn't really know what to do with it, you know, so I honestly think if you were going to do it, I think some of the best gifts that I've done were painting of people's pets. Mm-hmm. And also painting of places.
Mm-hmm.
Like I gave my cousin Judy a painting of Winged Victory, mm-hmm. the statue from the Louvre.
Mm-hmm.
And that was her favorite piece of art. Mm-hmm. And I was there in the Louvre sketching it.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, I think those mean a lot mm-hmm. more than, because who wants to look at a picture of themselves? Not saying that I don't like when you guys send me pictures of me. It's just,
right.
you know, there's only so much of that. Could you imagine if you walk into someone's house and they have pictures of them all over the
place,
you know,
it yeah. would,
but, so I don't know if you guys can see it. It seems to be a little bit more purple on this, but there's
yeah,
a lot of purples.
And, not.
Yeah.
The other one is more, definitely
okay.
more purple.
Yeah.
I would say some of the best art that you've given me is you did a picture... A painting of our boys that I still have up in my...
God, it was such a bad paint.
I love that one. Stop it.
Our kids are so ugly.
They're half me and that makes them gorgeous.
Well, that was the ugly part I was talking about. But okay, fine.
You've also done paintings for people when they've moved of their homes. Memorials of pets.
Yeah.
You know, things like that that you think people would enjoy, you know? Yeah. Let's see. Dalton says, hey, Scott, I really love your morning doodles. And also a question, didn't your watercolor palette used to have words on it?
It did. You can kind of still see it, but you know, they're just kind of worn out. But I know all the colors now. There's... On the gouache one, you could see them a little more because I don't use it as much.
Mm-hmm. And that's Sharpie. He wrote on that with Sharpie. How do I know what to draw? That's Mr. Ketchup.
By what you're looking at. You pick the thing you want to draw, and then you draw that thing. And that is either a photograph or in real life. But that's how you know what to draw.
Scott went to Academy of Art in San Francisco. We've never been to Australia, and I'm not sure we're going to go. You have those big huntsman spiders, and I don't know what that's... I just don't know if I can do that. Do you think you'll sell your gothic vampire like your other paintings, or are you going to keep it? Oh, the original.
Oh, the original?
Yeah.
I don't think so. I will say this. After seeing the poster for so long, the original isn't looking as cool because the original, you can't see the crosshatching as well. And so there's a bit of, God, it looks better in the print because I went and I had saved the inks, mm-hmm. and I kind of went over it. But here, I'll show you guys so you guys can see what I'm talking about.
The white outline is either a white Prismacolor pen, the Uniball Signo pen that is white, or sometimes you even use gouache for your white.
Yeah.
It's a hodgepodge.
Here's the original. Mm-hmm. You can see how you can't see the crosshatching in the back anymore.
No, you can't.
And whenever I do it, it just gets shiny because it's not sitting on top of the opaque gouache and inks and stuff that I have back there. Mm-hmm. I like how vibrant this red is.
Yeah.
But I think it'll look fine in the distance. But after looking at the print, I think I have a one here.
You want me to grab it, or do you?
Okay. After, well, you can't see it. I want to go like that.
You were pinching it.
Yeah. But after seeing, you know, after seeing it, I love the details in there, and I just can't seem to get that again.
Yeah.
But, you know, I might, maybe one day, I might spray it. You know, like I'll practice and see if a spray fixative will let me ink over it again, and then go back in and re-ink it, and that will make me happy.
Mm-hmm. Scott loves his cross-hatching.
Yeah.
Mm. Jay says, I was inspired to buy a white Signo pen for highlights from Scott, and it's now a staple in my art bag.
Yeah. I wish they were more consistent, because a lot of times they just don't want to work, but I'm working on it. Okay, can I get Jake done in...
What's your favorite to wear, formal or informal?
Informal. I like casual. Mm-hmm. Was it casual? I like to dress nice, like what
nice
you guys
casual.
See me in. Like, I don't wear a vest around, but mm-hmm. like you'll see me in...
A button-up
in
shirt.
In the videos with the zoo and whatnot, a button-up shirt or sweater and mm-hmm. jeans and...
Nice shoes.
Nice shoes and whatnot. I like mm-hmm. that. It makes me feel a little... human, a little more normal.
No, a little more. You feel better about yourself when you dress better.
Yeah.
Scott's been drawing since he was 6 or 7. Have you ever worked without a photo reference?
Yeah. The October Bear. Those are all without photo reference. I've done. Here, I'll show you. I did.
Ellen says, can confirm, used my BFF for portrait practice and mailed it to her. She liked it but felt weird with it, so she sent it to her mom.
Yeah.
That's funny.
I this was years ago. This was 2018, so this was 5 years ago. I wanted to see if I could do out of my head like a comic strip. Yeah. So I did a spaceship one, and then I did like a fantasy one. Mm-hmm. And then you guys also see me when I'm doing the stuff with Kim Diaz Home. That's yeah. obviously just working from ink splotches, but I just don't like it as much. I just feel like I'm, a lot more lost and I prefer my art with photo reference. I think it feels more confident mm-hmm. with photo reference mm-hmm. and it feels very, I mean, If you look at the hijab mm-hmm. and the elf and the, can you see these? Is there too much shine?
There's a little shine on the hijab, but the other ones are fine.
Okay. That was photo reference, and that was photo reference, but obviously the hair and the backgrounds and all that. Same thing with this. I had... This was photo reference. This was clip art. And then, you know, so there's a lot of imagination that does go into it. Mm-hmm. But again, I feel more confident if I have photo reference, because I get my proportions. I can have something to look for lighting and whatnot. It doesn't mean I can't. It just means that I like my art better with photo reference. And mm-hmm. that is purely a personal choice. A lot of artists work better without reference because they like working from mm-hmm. their imagination. And I think that's an amazing talent that I just don't have.
Yeah. Steph's mom's in the chat. Hola, Yola.
Hello. Okay, so.
Let's see. Where are we? We talked about the white outline. Which do you like better, Octobear or Octavia?
Octobear. I really enjoyed Octobear.
Is one of those packs of kneaded erasers and pencils and more packs worth the money? I don't.
I personally like the just getting stuff as needed. I don't like buying stuff in packs. So for me, it's I think it's mm-hmm. it's worth it to just buy what you need. Buy the needed erasers, they're 60 mm-hmm. cents. Buy the pencils that you need, buy mm-hmm. you know, all of that.
Okay. Let's see.
Changing his
I'm happy stimming at the fact I got mentioned. I love watching Scott unwind.
Well, I'm happy so stimming cute, hearing that you're happy stimming.
How are we both doing at the moment?
We're doing good. You know, I think things are okay. We're trying to see if we can go on a little break, maybe to a beach somewhere, just to take a couple days to just
unwind.
But there's, you know, there's like, well, we haven't gone anywhere mm-hmm. this year, like outside of the country. Should we do that? Or mm-hmm. you know, is it going to be too cold?
Anywhere we want to go is too cold right now.
Yeah.
And Scott doesn't do cold well.
I don't, but you know, like, it's like, should we go to like Ireland or Scotland or whatnot? Should we go to Italy? Should we, like, you know, we're looking at cheap airfare and just seeing what our options are.
Whoops.
Oh. But we're doing good. We're doing good.
Yeah, we're all right. We have hit some bumps in the road this year, but
lots of bumps.
Yeah, this year's been like a driving through the red rocks in Utah.
Yeah.
It's like you're constantly having something going. How can we copy other people's styles?
Everybody's different, but I mean, you could start with copying their art directly. Like exactly. Or you can start with just taking elements, like I've seen different people take the white outline from what I'm doing, mm-hmm. and they go, look, I'm doing a white outline, mm-hmm. I'm doing the Scott Sawa style, and that's just taking one element of what I do. Mm-hmm. You could take the mediums that I use, watercolor and ink and whatnot, the subject matter. A lot of it is you're taking what you like about a different artist, mm-hmm. and you're applying it to your art. Mm-hmm. That's how you learn. That's what I did with Alphonse Mucha. This is, you know, like the breaking the panel is from all of the comic book artists mm-hmm. that I used to like. Mm-hmm. The outline is from Drew Struzan's art. The inking is from comic books. So my color palette is from a lot of artists that I liked growing up. So these are things that you just need to copy. And copy without fear. So many younger artists are so afraid of copying and tracing, and that is how we learn. That is how we grow. Mm-hmm. And tracing is something I still do all the time. I mean, lots of times I will literally just project a face. I'll even sometimes do that for a lot of the videos that you're seeing me do. I'll just go, I don't have the time. Mm-hmm. I don't want to spend time getting the likeness exactly right. Mm-hmm. So I'm just going to project it real quick. Mm-hmm. Just get where all of here's where the eyes are. Yep. Here's what this is. Boom, done. It takes me 2 minutes to do that really quickly. Mm-hmm. And then I can confidently just look at the reference. But I do that all the time, mm-hmm. Just to kind of speed things up. Mm-hmm. And that's a tool that we're allowed to use. So copy your heroes. Copy artists that you like. You can see something in an advertisement. You could see something in on a wall somewhere, mm-hmm. and go, gosh, I like that. I mm-hmm. want to apply that to my, there's, mm-hmm. there's no copyright. Mm-hmm. There's no laws against that. That is mm-hmm. encouraged. And if any artist tells you, don't copy what I do and what I do is proprietary, don't listen to them. Go ahead.
Don't copy them and call it your own.
No, I'm saying if an artist says, don't copy my style, they didn't invent that style. They got that from the people before them. Mm-hmm. And so for someone to say, mm-hmm. stop, mm-hmm. I don't want anybody else to copy is wrong. Everybody mm-hmm. should be copying everybody and learning from it. It's like saying, if the Beatles said, okay, no one could do this.
Yeah.
Well, they didn't invent that.
That's true.
They got that from the musicians before them. Mm-hmm. And so if musicians were to say, okay, no one could use these musical notes in the same order.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous. And the same thing with art.
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry.
No, you're good. Scott, I'm doing November, and someone recommended doing a turkey, but I need more ideas.
Oh. November, you need more ideas.
Fall leaves, pumpkins.
Well, I think the costumes, they're doing costumes. Mm. So they're dressing up. I'd stay away from, like, pilgrims and stuff like that. I think that's a real political hot spot at this point.
Yeah.
You could do football. Football's a big thing. This is why I didn't do November.
Ooh, you could do a chef's hat. Do a chef, like, for baking and cooking.
Yeah.
Everybody bakes and cooks around the holidays. You could also do, like, somebody hiking outside. A lot of people love to be outside in the fall.
Yeah.
That's really good, too. Yeah, Australia and New Zealand are very expensive to get to, Brazen, so I'm pretty sure that's not going to be on the list right now since we have to go somewhere.
Unless there's a sale going on.
Yeah, relatively cheap. Iceland, not up Scott's alley right now. Liv says, this year has been rough. I totally get it. I finally got my driver's license, then got into a car accident a week later. However, I appreciate you guys always being here and being kind. I am sorry that you did that happened to you. This year has been...
We've had a few accidents here, too.
Yeah, we've had some car accidents. We've had some therapy. We've had some medication. We've had some...
Yeah.
We've had a whole lot of stuff go on this year. This year has not been kind to a lot of people. We've had people around us that have been very sick, and we get it. We absolutely 100% get it. But we're hoping that you guys can come here and be with us for 90 minutes and just feel a little bit of love and make a little bit of art, because that's really what we're trying to do.
I hate drawing hands, hate drawing hands. I'm going to sing the I Hate Drawing Hands song. Sorry.
Okay. There is a marker playlist. There are markers that Scott's tried. In the resources thing, and you can find those there. Chloe says, my style is copied from a mix of about 10 artists I enjoy, excluding yours.
Jaden just so I understand, is that because you don't enjoy my art, or you're trying to protect me somehow. Either way, please feel free to copy anything you see, but don't feel obligated to, obviously. I won't be hurt if you don't.
Let's see. Jaden's organizing a new marker set. Good luck with that. Let us know how it goes. I know that's difficult. Anne-Marie says, metal music wouldn't exist if we couldn't use ideas from other genres. It's heavily influenced by classical music. Hmm. Well, look at Kip Winger.
Wait, she said metal, honey.
I know, but I'm saying Kip Winger went, you know, was 80s and was like hair band, like, you know, and he's in doing classical now. Remember?
Okay, yeah.
That was my segue.
That was really weird.
Oh, okay. Well, that was my segue.
No one puts metal and Kip Winger in the same sentence is what I'm saying, but I see what you're saying. He was an 80s hair band.
Correct.
Who went from that to...
Classical.
Classical.
Correct. Okay. That's where I was going with that. Okay. Yeah. And boy, was he sexy in the 80s, and boy, has he lost it now. Woo! Poor guy. Anyway. You could do December and draw Christmas stuff in winter clothes.
I could.
Mm-hmm. Scott doesn't really like to draw a lot of Christmas stuff.
Santa's in the chat.
It might be because Donna overdecorates the entire house and has for 30 years. Let's see. Okay. Have we been to Spokane, Washington? It's beautiful in the fall. Really good opportunities at Riverfront Park and Minuto Park.
No, I don't think so.
I don't think so either. I've never been to Spokane. I've been to Vancouver. I've been to Seattle. I've been to Olympia, Tacoma. But I have never been.
I just realized what.
What?
I was like.
What?
The picture I'm using has Wilbur kind of looking this way.
Yeah.
And I'm drawing what he's looking at.
Oh, the treat bucket.
The treat bucket on the side.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I was like, why is
the keepers have this little pouch on the side, and
it has the fruit.
Oh, yeah. They keep all the treats in there. Oh, he's not stupid. He's incredibly smart. If you ever get into gaming, I feel like you guys would enjoy Stardew Valley. Isn't that the one you tried to get me to like?
No.
Oh, okay.
I tried to get you to like the Disney one. But no, I am a Legend of Zelda and Overwatch.
I'm not really a gamer.
No.
At all. Yeah. Do you like Metallica? And if you do, what's your favorite song from them?
I don't. My friend Dave, you know, really liked them, but no, I never got into metal. My best friend Dave is a total metalhead.
Oh, yeah.
And so we kind of met in the middle, like we would go to Whitesnake concerts or Striper or things like that, you know. It was in the 80s, but he would go to Iron Maiden, he'd go to Dio, he would go to
Queensryche.
Queensryche wasn't really metal, but yeah, you know, he would go to.
I'm trying.
I know. Donna hasn't really picked up the concept of metal.
Anybody
with long hair is metal.
Exactly.
Long hair and a guitar solo.
Yes, metal. That's correct. God, I love a good guitar solo, though. Oh, man. Yeah, nobody did guitar like the 80s.
All right, it's 10:25. I'm gonna ink and paint Jake and Wilbur later.
Okay.
We will call it a Monday. Thank you guys for hanging out. I think Wilbur came out pretty good, and
Wilbur's adorable. What, are you kidding me? All right. Yeah. So we'll let you guys go. Have a marvelous Monday. Thanks for being here with us, and we will see you guys on Wednesday. Bye, everybody.
Bye, everybody.